Salute, salute, salute. Before we get started, make sure to hit the likes, subscribe to the channel, and hit the dark notification bell so you get each and every notification for each and every video. Now let's get started. So the Knicks season starts on Tuesday, the preseason game against the Pacers at 7:30. And yes, these are the preseason games. On the surface, they don't mean much, but the team with so many new and developing pieces and such high expectations, as well as a coach who needs to show his own development, the preseason should be a barometer for the progress the players and the staff should have made from the weaknesses revealed from last season. The first player to analyze is Kemba Walker, starting point guard of the team after being signed after his release by OKC. The big elephant in the room is his left knee. How will this arthritic knee hold up? Again, the only thing he can do is strengthen the area around it and maintain the pain throughout the season. Whether he's going to take HA injections or rest and treatments, it's going to be a long season for Kemba Walker. We have to see how he can deal with it. But what I'm looking for in this preseason is to see, one, if he's actually going to play, and two, if he still has some of that explosiveness and bounce, at least some of what he had in his first season in Boston versus his second. If he isn't able to play, then maybe he isn't as healthy as he may have let on in some of the conferences he had once he signed with the Knicks. For Julius Randle, what I want to see has less to do with actual ability on the floor and more so with decision making. Again, it's the preseason, so a lot may not be executed on the court. But my concerns are all with the mental regarding Julius Randle. I would love to see him and Tibbs make adjustments based on what the defense is given, even if their vanilla offense is in the preseason. I'd like to see him get guys in proper position if they aren't. I want to see more of a facilitating playmaking Julius Randle outside of just the post-ups that he did last season. I'd also like to see Julius set better screens and actually play the pick and roll versus pop off the screen. Even if it's the preseason, his screen game has to be a lot more improved if Tibbs wants to incorporate more off-ball and motion-based offenses this season. Overall, for me, Julius has to play the game within the game. And if he wants to get to that Jokic level of dominant bigs, he has to display the ability to adjust on offense, just as the defense does. And what better way to test this out than in the preseason? The next guy up is my son, RJ Barrett, the young wing who's expected to make a major leap this year. Despite his evolution as a viable perimeter scorer, RJ still has a lot to prove with regards to his finishing, his dribble, and his mid-range game. He and Halen spoke on acceleration and deceleration, as well as shooting off the dribble as the main targets to work on this past summer. And we saw a little bit of in the summer in the FIBA games with Team Canada, especially shooting off the dribble. However, I think under Tibbs' more practical system, the shooting off the dribble will come in the mid-range. I want to see RJ Barrett be a little bit more cerebral with his mid-range game, where he's taking shots based on what the defense gives him and not just because of his plan A and what he wanted to do all along. I also want to see RJ Barrett not pick up his dribble so early. He did improve with his start and stop last season. We saw the hesitation dribble. But at 55% at the rim, RJ Barrett took too many linear takes to the basket. We picked up his dribble way too early, and the help defense or his defender was able to block it or alter the shot. Again, with RJ Barrett, I want to see a little bit more of the Jimmy Butler, where he has a proper opportunity to attack because he's keeping his dribble up or he's using hesitation to beat his man, or he's looking for the assist opportunity when somebody cuts or he could kick it back out to the outside. Again, with RJ Barrett, it's all about being more efficient because this season, he may not get more possessions given all the weapons on the team. So he has to be a little bit more efficient with the takes that he does have on this team next year. With Evan Fournier, it's more of an indication of how much the offense has expanded under Tibbs. Evan Fournier, as many know, is an excellent off-ball player and a really good catch-and-shoot weapon, as well as fairly decent on the ball, especially in the pick-and-roll. His experience with more off-ball schemes like the flex, the spin pick-and-roll, the stagger screen plays is something that Tibbs tried to run last season, but to little avail given the fact that we didn't have too many weapons who can execute it properly. And his experience with the horns and the pistol is something that Tom Thibodeau can definitely depend on, given the fact that Tibbs lived and died by it last season. Now again, the Knicks may not show anything crazy during the preseason, but if they start to show some new wrinkles, that'll definitely be an indication that Tom Thibodeau is expanding the offense. Mitchell Robinson is still not sprinting or playing with any contact, which is somewhat of a red flag. He's been participating in light jogs, but nothing heavy. At this point, I doubt he'd be ready for the start of the regular season. So the eyes would most likely be on Jericho Sims, who showed some impressive spurts on the rebounding end and wasn't afraid to assert his physicality in traffic during the summer league. He even took a few hook shot moves and even a three-point attempt during the summer league. Now, Jericho Sims is on a two-way contract, so he's most likely not going to get any minutes over guys like Nerlens Noel or Taj Gibson if Mitchell Robinson is still out for an extended period. But I would love to see Jericho Sims assert himself a little bit more on the offensive rebounding end, continue to use a hook shot when he has an opportunity, continue to throw his body in traffic whenever he's down there with two or three defenders trying to get the rebound from him, or two or three guys on offense trying to get the offensive rebound away from him. I'd also like to see Jericho Sims not put himself in so much foul trouble. Too many times he got himself into these ticky-tack fouls, putting his arms over the ball handler, uses physicality all wrong. So I'd definitely like to see him be able to shuffle his feet a little bit better, know how to use his body balance to disrupt the ball handler or potential score whenever they're going up for the shot. But overall, I'm expecting Jericho Sims to be in the G League unless he makes some Emmanuel Quickly type of impression in the preseason. Now to the rest of the bench, I don't expect a major change from what we've seen from the elder statesmen like Derrick Rose, Alec Burks, Dwayne Bacon, or Taj Gibson. But guys like Emmanuel Quickly and Obi Toppin have a lot riding on the development this season. For Quickly, the preseason will show if he can sustain some of the facilitating development he displayed during the summer league, where he did average about 7.8 assists a game, but he did have bouts of holding on to the ball too long. But he was also playing alongside guys like Wayne Seldon and Reed Travis, no offense. With NBA talent around him during the preseason and the regular season, I'm looking to see if he can make the proper dribble drive kickout or the through pass to a rolling player or the kickout to a player on his flank before the defense sees it on the break. Although I still see him as a combo guard, Tibbs likes his combo guards to be versatile on and off the ball. If he can display greater court awareness, which I believe is hard to do in the NBA level if you don't have it already, he can alleviate the pressure on Kemba and allow Rose to man the bench unit, where he has an important but indirect role in developing Obi, which we'll get into. If he can display greater court awareness, which I believe is hard to do in the NBA level if you don't have it already, he can definitely alleviate the pressure on Kemba Walker. If Kemba Walker's hurt and can't play, IQ can possibly start, and that would allow Derrick Rose to man the bench unit. I'm also looking for a mid-range game by Quickly, something that he noted he was working on during the summer. Last season, he shot 37% from the total mid-range, but that also included the floaters. Either way, 37% from the mid-range is not good. And he shot 31% from the long mid-range, which should probably point to more pure shooting. Also need to see Quickly be able to adequately go on his left side, something he struggled with last season. Now, he looked a lot better in the summer league, but the summer league is a summer league. Too many times in the regular season last year, he was a victim of aggressive double teams that took away his right. So if Quickly wants to become a multifaceted combo guard, he has to be able to drive on both the right and the left. As for Obi Toppin, the biggest question to me is whether he can operate from Derrick Rose. Now, like I said, Derrick Rose is going to be pivotal to his development this season in terms of getting Obi Toppin the ball out in space or on the fast breaks, using his pace to run with Obi Toppin, which is his natural skill. Be able to get to Obi Toppin out on the perimeter, get it to him in the post, be able to run the pick and roll with Obi Toppin. But with Obi Toppin, I gotta see if he can also develop offense away from Derrick Rose. Now, look at the difference in Obi's statistics when Rose was in the lineup and when he wasn't. Points per 100 possessions, shooting percentages from all over the court outside of the non-corner three were all higher when Derrick Rose was playing alongside Obi Toppin. So this season is about seeing how much Obi can develop away from Derrick Rose. And we saw a little glimpse of Obi Toppin's post-up game in the summer league where he'll take two or three dribbles and take the hard spin towards the baseline for the finish. We also saw Obi Toppin a lot more confident on the ball and attack, although he struggles with the help defense of the second level defenders once he beats his initial man. I want to see that confidence in the preseason, as well as smart decisions on the ball once he beats his first defender. He doesn't always have to look for the attack after he beats his first defender, but look for the kick out on a drive, which shouldn't be impossible given the decent court awareness he displayed in college, or the mid-range game, which he took several times in the summer league, but I want to see it a little bit more on the higher level. Next up is my son Miles McBride, who's in a greater position this season with Luka Podolski recently waived. He might get some rotational minutes given Kemba's knee situation and the overall expected hit to the backcourt defense, even though I'm not sure how Tom Thibodeau is going to set it up. He showed spurts of his underrated offense during the summer league, but I want to see him continue to make shots off the dribble, something he kind of was average at in college. He did show the ability during the summer league, but he had some inconsistent games. He had some really nice games, such as the one against the Hawks, but he also had the bad game against the Pistons. I'd like to see more consistency. Also, his form, even though I'm not a shot doctor, he does have a different form on catch and shoots versus shots off the dribble, where he's getting that proper lift. On some of the catch and shoots, he's kind of stationary, doesn't get much lift on a shot and releases really high. So if the coaches deem that he needs to change up a little bit just to be consistent this season, I would definitely like to see that occur, but if it works for him, it works for him. I wouldn't kill him too much, but again, I'm looking for this dog to somehow get some type of minutes this season because I know that Tom Thibodeau would definitely be impressed by his play and his absolute alpha mentality. If he could somehow make an Emmanuel Quickly impact during the preseason, there's no way that Tom Thibodeau doesn't get him at least 5 to 10 minutes somewhere. With Quentin Grimes, I doubt he gets significant minutes this year, but the things I like to see him improve upon in the preseason, or at least hope that he's improved upon once the summer ended, is his operation in the pick and roll. Learn how to effectively compensate for his lack of overall speed and quickness by using more guile, trapping his defender on the hip, on the attack deeper into the paint, be able to draw fouls on overzealous defenders trying to reset onto him after the pick. I also like to see consistency in his unguarded catch and shoots. He still seems like more of a rhythm shooter than a dependable knockdown hitter. So he needs to be more consistent when defenders aren't around. Lastly, I like to see Grimes keep his feet on the floor. He's a capable lateral defender, but many times, especially during the summer league, he got caught with his feet in the air. And in the NBA, even in spot minutes, savvy ball handlers will make him pay. So I'm hoping to see some improvement on the pick once the preseason starts. And with Kevin Knox, I doubt he'll have much impact this season. But given his comments on the summer league and the difference between what he said and what Tibbs said, he kind of has a lack of overall perspective, which is something that I noted on him since he was drafted. Honestly, I would probably just move on from Knox. I'm just hoping he gains some perspective in the league if he wants to stay in it, hopefully for his next team, because I doubt he's probably going to be here too long. But overall, good luck to you, Knox. Last but not least, Tom Thibodeau, who I don't expect to throw much in the preseason, given that's the preseason, you're probably going to be seeing a lot of vanilla offenses, but I would definitely like to see if they've been trying anything over the summer, especially if they're incorporating more off-ball offenses to the schemes. I'd like to see if they're going to add some stuff like some four-out concepts, which would be really cool. I'd like to see if they're going to experiment more with the Spain pick and roll, something they tried last season but just didn't have the horses to properly initiate, even some variations of the horn sets. This is definitely some things that Tom Thibodeau can do now that he has the horses, especially more of the off-ball kind, and guys like Fournier, developing RJ Barrett, even Kemba Walker, who's an excellent off-ball shooter. But guys, let me know what you guys think. What do you want to see in the preseason? We'll be covering here on Legion of Knicks, 6:30 for the Pacers versus Knicks game on Tuesday. Be here with me on the watch along. But guys, hit the like, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you hit the dark notification bell so you get notifications for each and every video I put out. And until then, guys, peace and loot. God bless. We out. Bless up.